equally rich in tales of warrior queens and heroic kings, of wizards and witches, and of strange creatures that grudgingly share their home with us humans.
I've always been fascinated by these fabulous fairy tales, magical mysteries and mysterious legends.
So I'm traveling the length and breadth of this country to discover their weird and wonderful truths. My journey takes me from colossal mountains.
He says of you to stir the loins of any Welsh man or woman.
To murky caves.
Bloody hell, I'm virtually on my knees now.
To places where sorcery might once have taken place.
This is where the real magic is, Jonathan.
Yeah, and welcome, Morgan.
Meeting the people who share my enthusiasm for the witch mysteries of the past.
The deeper meanings of myths and legend, I think, is because they speak to a more irrational part of ourselves.
I absolutely do believe in Loch Ness Monster because I've seen it with my own eyes.
I hope to find out the story behind the legends.
According to Geoffrey of Monmouth, this is where King Arthur was actually conceived.
How they began, and what truth, if any, might lie at their core.
Dracula himself, on the surface, he looks like a normal gentleman, but there's this beastly, this demonic side to him.
And why these ancient legends continue to resonate with us in the age of mobile phones and Wi-Fi.
More than ever, this is the kind of imagery that is so important for the younger generation to understand.